other day I went to Tomo Fair Rotterdam, and they had some really fun things to do there. One of them was organized by the company called Red Dot. They are an anime company, they sell anime goods, merchandise and stuff. But they also host Ichiban Kuji, which is a Japanese type of lottery. You buy a certain prize, in this case it was €12.50, to draw a ticket, which is a closed piece of paper. Then when you open it, there's a letter inside, and the letter corresponds to one of the prizes. You always win something, but most of the prizes are small keychains and stuff like that. And usually the biggest prize, so A, would be a really cool figure, then the B prize would be a slightly less popular character figure, and then so on and so on, and then the least best prize would be usually it's like a keychain or a little canvas. So my boyfriend and I tried it three times. The first time we both bought a ticket, and we both got one of the slightly less good prizes. So my boyfriend, I forgot which letter he had, but he got this. Can you already tell which anime this is from? It's from That Time I Got Reincarnated as a Slime. And this is actually Rimuru. I can't tell if you can see his face, but he's in yellow. This was actually a blind box, so there were different kinds of, well, this little figure, I guess. But we got unlucky and we had the yellow one. I really wanted the blue one because Rimuru is blue, so. But on the other hand, I won this prize, which is actually blue, but it only came in blue. It just had different faces. So this is the E prize. I think my boyfriend may have had the G prize. So this is E. It's actually a little towel. I think it's meant for your face or your hands, but I haven't really decided what to do with it yet. So we didn't get very good prizes, but it's kind of hard to win one of the big prizes. We've participated in the Ichiban Kuji before, and my boyfriend once won the first prize, and he's kind of addicted to these kinds of lottery things, because if you win once, you might win again. So we just went around the con, it was kind of fun. We looked at some other stands, we bought some other stuff that I'll show you in a while. But just before we left, my boyfriend was like, let's try again. I have a good feeling about this. I want to try the lottery again. So he tried the lottery again, and he didn't win the first place, also not second place, but he won third place, and it was actually a really fun one. So this is the C prize. It's Rimuru! It's really soft. If you can, I don't know if you can see it, but it's kind of textured. Probably to make it more poofy. I don't know. But it's really soft. And now I have a Rimuru of my own. But before he won this prize, he actually bought me this. It's an actual figure from That Time I Got Reincarnated as a Slime. My camera doesn't want to focus on his face. There we go. It's Rimuru. So there you go. I really like this part because it reminds you of how Rimuru is a slime, and it's see-through, and the color changes as it goes down to the base. It's actually one of those arcade prizes, I think. But then I also bought one of the figures that I've wanted for a really long while. But it's not from that time I got reincarnated as a sign. It's a Miku figure. So a while ago, Miku Expo actually went to Amsterdam and we also went to that concert. It was really, really fun, but they didn't really sell any figures and I don't have a Miku figure yet. I only have one of the Nendoroids, one of the Snow Miku ones. I forget which year it is, but I didn't have a full scale, real scale model of her yet. And I've seen this one pop up online and I just think it's so adorable. Also, I love Easter. It's not really, I don't really celebrate Easter, but I just really like the colors. And my birthday is around Easter, so I just associate Easter with my birthday. And I really like all the pastel colors and the cute buddy designs. So yeah, I think that's it. Maybe I can tell something about the con itself. It was kind of fun. It was small, but I believe it's the smallest Tomo Fair. It's the first Tomo Fair I went to, so I can't really compare it with anything. What really stood out to me was that there was a lot of younger people. Me, I'm almost 29 now, 30 is coming up. But a lot of people seemed to be under 20 years of age, I think. So it was a lot of teenagers and young people there. And that's also the reputation that Tomo Fair has, because it's kind of cheap to go in, and sometimes they even hand out free entry tickets. So lots of younger people feel compelled to go because they can just hang out with their cosplay friends for cheap. I didn't really meet a lot of people that I knew, besides the people that are running the stands, because they are at every con, so I recognize them. And overall, I think it was pretty fun. They had some food, but not very much. I think they can expand on that because the lines were pretty long for the food stands. And they didn't allow for outside food to go in. Also, if you left the fair, you weren't allowed to go back in, so you can't just go to the supermarket and buy a drink or something. Then you aren't allowed back in, so that's a little, I don't know. I can see why they did that, because then they don't have to make badges or stamps on your hand or those bracelet type of things. So I can see why they do it. It's a lot easier that way for the people who run the fair. But yeah, it was a little annoying that you could only buy the food at the con. Also, the karaoke was kind of loud. It was all in one big building. There were a few things that were in separate rooms. Maybe they should have done the karaoke in a different room, because it was kind of loud, and if you're just there shopping, it's a little annoying. But overall, I really liked it. It was pretty busy. I don't know if it was sold out, but it kind of seemed that way. And yeah, it was a pretty nice event. We mostly just bought a lot of stuff, because this isn't even everything. Yeah, some of the stuff I already put away, so that's why I can't show it to you. That's my dog barking. A car just passed by. I guess it's time to end this video, so hopefully until next time, and let me know what you thought in the comments below. Bye bye!